Hello, RichieV here, and today I am back for another nostalgia review. A nostalgia review is where I look back at something with rose-tinted glasses to see if it still holds up today. Now, the song I'm going to look at today is a song called I've Done Everything for You. If you went through the 80s, you know this is a Rick Springfield song, right? Rick Springfield, you know, he was good looking. I think he was an actor before he was a musician. I mean, before he hit it as a musician. And all the girls loved him because, ooh, it's Rick Springfield. Anyway, the point is, it's actually not a Rick Springfield song. It is actually a Sammy Hagar song. So as a Sammy Hagar fan, I said, why don't I look up and see if there's anything on YouTube where Sammy Hagar is talking about, you know, creating the song, I've Done Everything for You. And so let's just take a look at it, and then I'll let it roll as he plays his version of the song. And we'll see, you know, I think a lot of people still may like the Rick Springfield version, but that's perfect okay, because that's nostalgia. So anyway, let's take a look at Sammy Hagar talking about I've Done Everything for You.
How you doing, baby? Wow. Yeah. Are you from around here? Oh, no. I didn't think so, because people can hear from around here. Okay. Have a drink. Have you been drinking already?
A little bit,
my ass. Here, walk this line backwards and then recite the alphabet backwards. And yeah, there you go. Okay, that's enough. Okay, you're going to jail. Okay. Hey, stick around. I gotta ask you something. I got a little story. So, a long time ago, like 1977. Are you nervous? Let's see. Are you shaking? That's a vibrator.
Sammy's funny.
Oh, I'm getting
funny
guy. This shit, trust me. Anyway, so in 1977, I released this song, and it was a bomb. You know, my record company and my manager went and said, oh boy, this is going to be the biggest hit you ever had. And we released it. It was a fucking stiff. Right? That sucker was still born, right?
Yeah.
So, no big deal. Wasn't my first one. So, kind of like this cocktail. But anyway, so I said, you know, went about my business, went on tour for, you know, my whole life, and along comes this guy 5 years later and records my song, and it goes number one in every country in the world.
Yeah. Rick Springfield.
No, it's the truth. And so, it was some bullshit to it, but the truth of the matter is it was true. I didn't mind. Shit, man, I'm sitting there going, I never have to work again. But anyway, so this guy... I don't even want to say his name. It's going to be a problem.
Rick Springfield!
No, he's all right. The guy's all right. But so I met the guy. His name was Rick Springfield. Look at the girls. Woo! Hey, listen. I'm aging better than him, okay? So he goes. So I meet Rick, and I said, Rick, why the hell was this song number one for you as a bomb for me? And he said, swear to God, he said, dude, I'm better looking than you. At the time, maybe. But what do you think about that?
I think my mama loves you.
I can't get no respect up in this butt.
Choose there for my first pause. Sammy Hagar is just a great showman. He is an amazing showman. A lot of people talk about Van Halen versus Van Hagar, and honestly, I like more of the early Van Halen stuff. But Hagar, when he was with Van Halen, he put on a show. He wasn't stumbling around the stage drunk and forgetting the lyrics. When they did live, with Sammy Hagar, they were playing amazingly great. So, but anyway, this guy's a showman. I'm going to keep it up. I might have to pause one more time, but let's get going. I was enjoying that song so much I forgot to pause twice. That's okay, these things all get claimed anyway. Okay, so that was Sammy Hagar, and that was my nostalgia review with my rose-tinted glasses. And you know what, I really like Sammy Hagar. I like his rocked up version of the song. I know for those of you who were there in the 80s and you were used to Rick Springfield, that's going to be your favorite version of the song. And quite frankly, it's a great version too. I think their rivalry is more for stage. I think they get along personally. But that's okay. This was Sammy Hagar. I've done everything for you. If you liked it, hit like or subscribe, you know, yada, yada, yada. And until I see you next time, have a blessed day.